In today's lesson, we're going to look at the ROTATE3D command. We're continuing on from these objects that we created in the previous lesson. Remember that we rotated the UCS, so we still have this UCS here along the wedge that we created. If you remember how to get back to the world coordinate system, you type in UCS, and then you type W for world, and then press enter. And so your world UCS icon is always going to look like this, where your X and your Y are pointing left and right, and your Z is in a straight up and down position. Let's look at these circles here. Both of these circles are drawn flat in plan view. Remember, we've got these two axes. We've got the X axis and the Y axis here. Let's say if we wanted to rotate this up so that it would match the orientation of this circle on the left side of the cube. Well, the way that we would do that is we would rotate it along this Y axis. So think of the Y axis as like a hinge, like you're opening up a door or a hatch. You've got this hinge of rotation. So the way that you go into the 3D rotate command, just type in RO for rotate, and then use your arrow key, and then press enter to make sure you've selected Rotate 3D. Then you choose the circle that you want to rotate, press enter, and then you come down to your command line and you choose the Y axis, or you can just simply type in Y for the axis that you need. And then we're going to select the center of the circle, or you could select the quadrants if you want, but we've got the center snap turned on. And then we're going to be pointing the cursor in the same direction as this Y axis that you see in the UCS icon. And then we're just going to left click. And that's going to orient that circle the way we want it. Let's just go into the side view here to look at that. So next, let's practice a couple of things. So we're going to take this by crossing, and we're going to type in the M command, and we're going to move this up to this corner here. So now we have an object like this. Now let's say we wanted to rotate this whole piece so that it lays flat on this plane down here, essentially just turning it on its side. So think of it again as a hinge. So we're taking the hinge, or this axis here, which happens to be the X axis, and we're going to be just flopping it on its side. So let's type in the 3D rotate command again, select these by crossing, press enter. Remember, it's the X axis, specifying the point on the X axis, which would be here, or it could be here. And then we're just going to simply rotate our cursor to this point here. You can kind of see it flipping along this axis here, but we want it to be in this position here. So we're just going to point our cursor up this way. And now you can see it laying flat, just like we wanted. Now let's take this wedge here and then move it up this way here. And now let's flip this thing back on its side again. And think about the axis that we'll be needing in order to rotate that or hinge that whole object around. So it's going to be this axis here, because we'll be flipping it this way on top of the cube. So again, let's select the wedge, type in RO for rotate, Rotate 3D, and that's going to be our X axis again. Type in X, we'll choose the point here, and it's just a matter of flipping that over this way and then choosing the point out here, just left clicking. Now keep in mind, I do have my ortho mode turned on. Super important. Make sure the F8 key is turned on. as we're rotating this around because we want this to snap to this angle. Now finally, let's first erase this circle here, and let's take these two circles and move them into this plane by the midpoint of this wedge here. So the way we would do that is we select these objects here, we type the M command in, we want to move it from the center of this circle here, and then we're going to use the M2P command, one of my favorite shortcuts, and we're going to move it so that it's between these two corners on this wedge. And lastly, we're going to rotate this circle here so that it's flat against the incline on this wedge. So think about the axis in this situation. It's a little bit different in that the axis is actually determined by the midpoint of each side of that wedge. As we know, the circle here is intersecting that wedge by the midpoint of these two corners. So let's go ahead and select these two pieces here, type in the RO, and then selecting Rotate 3D. And I'm not going to define the axis by typing X or Y. I'm just going to select the midpoint here and the midpoint here. And if you don't define that axis in the beginning, it's just going to ask you for those two points. And so now it's just a matter of locating the circle how we want it. It's going to be on this angle here. So in this lesson, we practiced the Rotate 3D just by typing RO and selecting it from drop down, and then defining the axis by either typing in X or Y, or by just selecting two points, defining the axis itself. Remember that the axis of rotation can simply be thought of as a hinge point. So really it's a three-step process. You're selecting the entities that you want to rotate. You're defining the axis or the hinge points. And then lastly, you're moving your cursor with the ortho locked or pressing the F8 key. Or optionally, you could use the F10 key to use polar tracking. And then just simply selecting the angle that you need to rotate those objects to.